They might be able to catch this thing on foot! Drive!
Okay, I'm helping with the shooting this time. You can't carry me through this like you did in the dim sum plaza.
Fantastic guys.
Thanks, Lou. Sweet of you to say so.
Assholes!
That's it. We're clear.
Jesus Christ!
That was a pleasant outing, Rock. Where's that put us with you know what? We square?
Square? What you borrowed? At those points? You ain't even making a dent on the interest. Besides, I'm about to have to do all the messy work on this guy myself.
No, but I told you shit. I told you everything.
I'll see you girls later.
Jesus!
Come on, let's head back to the apartment.
Hey, you know, I'm really warming to that guy. Like a bad case of crabs.
Crabs are easy to get rid of. Believe me on that one.
Thank you for sharing.
We're business partners. We share everything.
The emphasis is on business, bro. You can keep your crabs to yourself.
Sorry, man, but I really got us into shit here, Luis.
Tony, man, you gotta calm down. You're really pushing it.
Yeah, well, if you weren't out chasing tail, and this was a two-man operation like it should be, then maybe things will be holding together better.
Oh, I'm getting blamed for this now? Oh, of course. Whenever I come to the clubs, you ask me to run off on some stupid errand like a chump. You don't ever let me into the serious shit. And you do deals without even telling me. Until it comes time to protect your ass from whoever you got your fatwa the day
all
from.
All right. Maybe I've taken you for granted. I'll change. I'll be better.
Yeah, thank you. But I don't believe it. Here we are, bro. Rest up, okay?
Listen, Lou, would you mind paying Maury a visit? He says he needs help with something. I know he's a bit of a schmuck, but we owe the man money, and I don't want him anywhere near the clubs.
I feel you there, T. That guy is a social atom bomb. I'll go see him.
Sorry, bro, but you're getting jacked.
What the fuck?
TNT. Hey, have you a light?
Hey, sorry, Papi, I don't smoke.
Ah, a Spaniard. Wonderful. A man of culture.
I'm not sure someone from the heist qualifies as being Spaniard, but whatever.
Oh, exactly. Whatever. Whatever you say, Daddy.
Excuse me?
What is wrong with you? The British, they give you this beautiful, if a little awkward language, and you just debase it with whatever, or like, or fuck you, or get over yourself.
In that case, fuck you.
Oh, c'est ça, on va te faire foutre. Oh, who am I to complain? My country is not much better. We are the worst. My people watch American television and then they complain about it afterward. Oh la la, I am rich! Time was when we would chop someone's head off and we would run around the street with it on a stick. Vive la France! Now, we are soft and miserable just like you.
Hey, I'm not miserable.
Well, then clearly you do not watch enough television. You enjoy the bright lights and the big cities and the hope that maybe one day you become rich and stupid and your people. Maybe you can make a nice little TV show with you and your friends.
Hey, knowing my friends, I hope not.
Well, I do not come to Liberty City to watch television. I come to fuck and get high. What else is there?
Well, I don't know. Family?
I had a family. Meaningless. Honor? Psst. Don't make me puke. No, mon ami. I had to tell you, my friend. Nothing matters in this world apart from getting your rocks off. Or getting so out of it you don't realize you haven't got your rocks off.
I like a man who's so focused.
Have you got a car?
I'm not sure I want to get into a car with someone like you.
Oh, relax, relax. Let's go for a drive. I like you. You find things as ridiculous as me.
I have an appointment at the Hyatt Massage Spa on Diamond Street.
Hello, Father.
Can I buy a massage for you? It's the least I can do considering your many kindnesses.
Nah, I'm cool, bro. I don't need no slave labor fluffing. I like things giving up willingly.
As you wish, but there are pleasures distinct to the professional mistress. You may come to understand that in later years, Spaniard.
Yeah, okay, Frenchman.
Thank you, Spaniard. I am only sorry you will not join me in this adventure.
Don't catch nothing, bro.
Into you. Why haven't you been helping out at the clubs?
You serious, man? I've been running around this city getting shot at by assholes, doing hits for assholes, and hanging out with assholes so we can keep these places running. What else you expect me to be doing?
Standards have slipped, Lou. We're dead without this revenue stream. Just keep an eye on things, okay? Desi's at Masonette every night. Just talk to him and he'll explain everything.
Okay, T. Put your feet up. Relax. Enjoy yourself.
Come again!
carpet smoking.
I completely understand.
Insieme no, le donne van bene con tutto.
How are you, Daisy? You never call me.
Sorry, Leslie. Yeah, I'm great, marvelous. Listen, have you got any coke?
No, sorry.
Not to worry, I don't need it. I more or less stopped doing it now. I only do it at night now. It's so good to see you, darling. How is darling Terry?
You mean Tony?
I love that man. Just a shame he's a pup.
Yeah, a lot of people say that about him. Anyway, I thought you said you were going back to London.
I did. Yes, I did. I came back. I was actually just about to call you when my phone got stolen.
Don't worry about it.
What? Well, I didn't know we were being filmed. Was that a fucking hand job? Oh, fucking cunt!
What's wrong?
My fiancé. Shit! Shit, shit, shit!
What?
Shit!
You said that.
Oh, my fiancé! Fuck! Listen. Oh, when you say it out loud, it sounds really awful. And I'm not a slapper.
A what?
So, anyway, I was really drunk. But anyway, you know Chris Hunt?
The gay action star?
He's not gay! He's a virile man who takes an interest in personal grooming and likes gladiators. But... yes, he's probably a bender. So anyway, I got off with him, ended up getting taped, and now he's going to leak it online to prove he's straight. That wanker!
The classic blind beard.
Oh, and if my fiancé finds out, I'll be buggered. Oh, please, please, darling, I need your help.
Fine.
Oh, come on, let's go. Man, I wish we had some coke.
We need to find this twat. Fuck!
You don't know where he is?
He's always on that bloody bleater website. We'll wait until he bleats and then we should be able to find him.
Show me that. His last bleat says he's taking a crap looking over Middle Park. We're gonna head uptown.
Posted a bleat.
What? What did it say?
He's bleated. Marcus asked me if I hang left or right, and I told him to find out for himself.
What could that possibly mean?
I think he's getting his inner seam measured at a tailor. All Chris's suits are made by that darling little man at Perseus. We should go there.
He's getting his tailor to check his Johnson? And you say this guy ain't gay?
All I know is I wanked him off, okay? I mean, you and I had sex, and you're a bit fruity, so it wouldn't exactly be a first.
You say so.
Oh, sugar, that's sweet, but a girl knows.
Then maybe I've been hanging out with Tony too long. Or maybe it's you. Is your fiancé gay too? Is that like a fetish for you?
Oh, Bertie's had some flings. But he's pretty much 70% hetero, as much as any privately educated Brit can be.
Your private schools are like our prisons then.
I wouldn't know about that, sweetheart. But if you're speaking communal showers and anxious fumblings in the meadow, then perhaps.
Missed him, did we?
Apparently his fingers haven't smelled this fishy since he last crossed over.
Good for him.
He must be at Squid Row, that budget seafood place. He loves slumming it there for some reason.
Yo, okay. Worst case scenario, a video comes out. You lay low for a while. Maybe get a reality TV show.
The new American dream. Sweetie, just what I want. Mummy and Daddy would be so proud.
Some other girls would kill to be in your position. Think of it that way. Enjoy the ride.
Good for those tramps. I'm a respectable woman. I've had $200,000 spent on my education. Daddy's got a peerage. I was babe of the month, for God's sake. I don't want to be famous for tossing up some sodomite. Jesus, I need some coke. Fuck! Your fucking Spanish gave me some.
Star Junction it is, then. What movie is he premiering?
I don't know. Something where he beats people up and pretends to be straight.
Standard Viewer shit, then.
Pretty much. They've always been like that, haven't they? To him. Chris, you cunting fuck, hand over the tape.
Too late, Dolly. You're gonna be famous. Check it.
Oh my God! Is that my Minge? He's 10 feet high!
You really just want to wank? We're not 12.
Give me some digits too, baby. 3 of them.
Fuck, fuck, fuck! My life is over!
Who's gay now, bitches?
See you later, babe. Couldn't have happened to a nicer person.
Thank you. Hey, Lou!
It's Luis.
Yeah, whatever. Come here, give me some love right here.
So what'd you want? Tony said you needed a favor.
Well, I look like a charity case to you.
Can I plead the fifth on that one?
Ah, oh, that's funny. You're funny. Yeah, you're fucking funny. Funny for a guy with all those pecs. But you got the lats of a little girl, and man, you need calf implants. Look at you. And, you know, I'm guessing just from looking at you, you ain't exactly packing a 10-inch hose, man. Me? I make girls wince. Wince.
Oh. Just to level with you for a minute, bro. Tony owes you money. Tony's my boss and my friend. So I'll help you out a little. But if you mention my host again, I'll put you in the fucking ground.
Jesus Christ, man. You're pent up. Come on. I didn't mean anything by it. I apologize. All right, look, let's rewind. We'll restart. We'll relax. Huh? Come here. Page one. Give me a hug. Huh? Give me a hug. That's it. Now, where were we? Oh, well, if it isn't my brother the ghost.
Maury, what are you doing here, bro? And who's this guy?
It's Lou.
It's Luis.
Right. Well, it's nice to see you too, little brother. Jesus, you look pale. What, somebody die?
Unfortunately not, man. What are you doing here, Maury?
I am thinking about moving back home. You see, I've been hearing some stories about you getting somewhat above yourself. And I'm worried about you.
Well, don't worry about me, man. I'm fine, okay? I'm gonna be just fucking fine.
Jesus, who is training you? Man ought to be horsewhipped. Look at you. You're lumpy.
Oh.
You're like awful, like a big pale mess. And you're fat, bro. You're fat.
Screw you, Maury, man. You're
perfect. Yeah. Chiseled, tan, handsome. I'm the dream ticket. Yeah, Mom always warned me that you were a lazy kid.
I bet you've been juicing. Of course I haven't.
Ugh. No. Yeah, I smell it on you. Fear. But I'm back now, baby B. I'm back.
Oh.
And your life just got fun again.
Come on, Lou. Let's roll. Oh, and Fat Boy. You better let your friends know about me, because kibbutz number one is back in town. And this time, it's kosher. See ya. Wouldn't want to be ya, fag.
Head on up the Bohan, will ya?
In 100 yards.
What you need done, Maury?
Oh, we got some very intense shit to handle.
Yeah, I'm hoping you mean you got some boxes to move. Something like that. That's about as intense as I'm willing to get for you.
Wow! That's incredible! He looks like a man, but he talks like a pussy.
Maury, man, you're a business guy, so you should stick to your business shit. Don't get involved in stuff that's out of your league because of some small man syndrome that makes you overcompensate.
Well, there's nothing small about what I got going on, Lopez. So you need me to take out the monster? I'll whap that shit on a dashboard and see what you think of it. Yo, you'll think it suddenly got dark in here. I'm talking serious block the sun shit. Oh, nah. They just don't hold me responsible for your inadequacy issues after that, huh? Oh.
Oh, don't take nothing out, bro. Keep it to yourself. Keep the monster away from me, and listen to what I'm saying. This shit comes from the heart, okay? I don't want to see you getting it over your head. For a man of your height, that's gotta be easy to do.
Whoa, slow up, dog. I think you're mistaken in your impression of me. I look like a civilian to you?
You look like a lot of things, bro. A lot of neurosis in one tiny package. Kind of like an army knife without the edge.
You think because of my lumpy little brother that I don't swing on the dark side?
Hey, I never said you weren't a swinger, man. Come to think of it, I might have seen you on one of the west sites.
All right, enough with the jokes. Look, I done 3 years Israeli military. I seen shit you wouldn't even believe.
Yeah, I done 3 years helping to run Hercules. I seen shit you wouldn't believe.
Hey, how many guys got the juice to get into some foreign legion shit when they're 18? You were probably still sucking on your mama's titty at that age.
I was doing time, bro. And leave my mama out of it.
Things I saw over there were insane, dog. Insane! I'd tell you about it, but then I'd have to kill you right here. I could do it too, with my bare hands. Wouldn't even think twice about it. But I won't, Lou. I won't, because I like you. And special forces don't even begin to describe my shit.
Special sounds about right to me.
Look, I came back here after the service, and I changed, man. I changed. You think it's easy sitting down at Econ 101 when you've been icing fools?
I wouldn't know, bro.
Still got my 4.0, though, didn't I? Oh, give it up, right here.
Yeah, good for you, bro. You want to send me a resume so we can skip all this personal history crap?
No, I want you to understand, Luis, that I got the brain and the brawn, the meat and potatoes. MBA plus IDF equals do not fuck with this bitch. I got it all, brother. I can handle anything.
Yeah, okay, fine, whatever. Remind me what we're doing now?
We are paying a visit to some of my old, business associates. We're gonna take over their operation. Clear those fucks out.
Perfect. Just perfect. Another fucking war.
Fuck yeah!
Calculating route.
You!
What the fuck are you doing here, Maury?
Oy vey, motherfuckers!
Dude, we told you, we ain't in business with you no more. You're a rip-off merchant.
No more cooperation, my friends. It's hostile takeover time. Hand it over.
Fuck you, Maury, you midget prick. You ripped us off for the last time. Let's get these fuckers!
Of them. I'll pay you, Fox!
Woo!
We did it, man! Now you can take me back to shore.
Hey, bro, I can't imagine you got much of a business left now that we've taken out all your employees.
Imagination isn't your strong suit, Luis. Let's leave the logistics to me, huh?
Hey, I'm more than happy to leave everything to you, Maury. In fact, I don't want to be no part of any of this shit.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but you and Tony are business partners, aren't you?
Sure.
Well, I own Tony. Ergo, I own your ass as well. Get used to it.
Hey, no one owes me, bro.
Ooh, I beg to differ.
Here we go, bro.
Woo! Sure I am, sure. Hey, you did great. I'm feeling real bullish about you, Lou. Real fucking bullish.
Good to know.
Hey, you come by soon. We got some more shit to discuss.